Hello everyone, this is General Yang, and welcome back to another Let's Play Shogun 2 Total War. So, we haven't enabled our Nobunaga army in a while, so I'm going to send them out to attack this army that's just been sitting here for a while. And I'm going to have this settlement get occupied by that reinforcing army of Naginata. Looks like Nobunaga could not quite get there, so I'm just going to continue sending these guys over, and I can take two units. Matchlocks or no matchlocks? No matchlocks at all. Akechi Toshikane shall march to the borders of the enemy. We'll occupy the settlement here. Have this guy also not be able to join in. I guess he can be the reinforcing army. Okay, so those two armies are just staying tight. And we'll have to end our turn here, as there's nothing much that we can do. Have these ships move along. Lots of ships just moving. And the Joseon Dynasty has, I think, 4 settlements left. Maybe 5. Actually, I'll just double check. Oh! They're trying to bribe my settlement away. What will happen? Okay, they bribed some men out of there.
It's a long-range siege weapon. These rockets are inaccurate, but devastating should they reach their target.
Oh man, we got fire rockets. This is awesome. We did lose some men to bribery. I wonder if I can recruit them here. The answer is no, but I can get some ninjas. I guess I'll get some ninjas. And fire rockets were in North Bungo. Luckily they are still relatively close. Oh yeah. Oh, this is gonna be awesome. Although we're probably not gonna be able to use them on the enemy. They're too far away. Well, I'll just recruit a bunch of them anyways. Ah, oh, they bribed so many of my men away. Well, let's convert you. Join the Oda Clan. Perplexed. He's gonna kneel. I mean, not kneel. He's gonna crawl. Oh, he's gonna go into that position right there, and he's gonna cry a little bit. Although losing that garrison was not good for us. Means we need to exempt them from taxes. And I guess we'll send this Korean force out to take him out. Or not. Now I'm gonna send them back to garrison that fort. Have these guys come back in. I'll take these guys and all of my archers to take out this army. These Yari Ashigaru have betrayed us, but at least we didn't lose the settlements. Probably could have been possible if I had kept fewer men in there. What? Wait, what? Well, whatever. I guess the roads are a little faster. So we have an army here that's just sitting. I'm gonna push them back into that settlement. No, I am not. They are just going to stand and fight. Although fire projecting mangonels. No losses on my side, to be expected, and it looks like they also have incense maker here. Huh. Nice. Oh, we're gonna take Songchun here. One Korean archer militia garrison, which is pretty sad. They barely have a garrison here. So one of the things is we can actually loot. since this is considered a foreign country, but I don't think the mechanics... I think you still lose honor with the mechanics that are in Shogun. There might be two settlements here. Metsuke here, I'm gonna have him do some exploring for me. He walks really, really slow. Anjumok will be at the border soon. We'll attack probably in the next turn. Did I end my turn? There we go. 33, wow. The man is already 33. We've been playing this for a while. So Korean Flail Cavalry. Some Royal Guards. Let's fight this one on the battlefield. There aren't too many battles left, and we may as well have some fun before this campaign comes to an end. Our first Shogun 2 campaign with the Morning Sun mod. And this is loosely based on like the actual Imjin War that Toyotomi Hideyoshi launched on the Korean Peninsula, which was actually very successful until he died. Well, until the Ming Dynasty decided to send reinforcements. That's when things started to stale out, and also the Navy. They just could not handle the Korean Navy. The ground forces were making a lot of headway. Okay, so got some great guards over here. Concentrate on the right side. Of the right flank, the Katana Samurai. Nobunaga will be over here. This guy should be group 5. Somehow I managed to screw that up. There we go. 3 and 4, and let's go. Oh, no movements by the enemy. Surprise. This army is actually really well experienced. I did not know that the Nobunaga army was this experienced, to be honest with you. I guess it's because we haven't actually been using this army for a while. So the Joseon forces are stationed right here. Caps is already shooting at us. I'll send out these guys to attack. Wow, they are already shooting at us. That is impressive. That is why we are rushing with our cavalry force and archers. Mostly just the archers. Ridiculous range. These guys are the equivalent of archer heroes for the samurai equivalent. And we're gonna let it rain. And we're just gonna burn these dudes right here in the forest. And, well, hello there. There's fire in the air. And you can see the Yari charging to it as well. So what's nice is when you do have them in long formation, they will charge in a freaking straight line. Which is exactly what I wanted them to do. What are these Royal Guards doing? Looking badass as usual, alright. I can respect that. No, there's no archers to hit. And the moment I say that... Wait, what? There are just like invisible archers here. Oh, green gorillas. That would explain it. I was like, where are these arrows coming from? Well, luckily I got my great guard here to flank him. And see you later, boys. We're just visiting. Now we're leaving. The archers are being routed. See you later, alligator. My men are marching through. Push on in, buddy. We're surrounding them. Archers are shooting down the center ranks. So the problem is that they don't have too much armor. So when we do attack, we do a lot of arrow damage. And we got caught in some form of conflict here, but we're gonna smash them in the back. Stop all archer fire. Now we're gonna try and stir them around. The flank. I mean, yeah, it's over. This is like, once you surround your enemy like this, and for whatever reason my katana samurais are completely lost. But that's okay. We've gotten this surround. Once you get this surround, it's over, man. Charging in. Flushing him down. Royal guards on the left flank, on our left flank. Now trying to chase down the enemies that are running away. The Tiger Hunter Force is still fighting. So we will regroup some of these men. These guys are all regrouping. We are forming a square. They have now been surrounded. Completely surrounded. And they were actually getting quite confused as to who they wanted to engage with at first. But since we know that we can't kill them one-on-one, we decided to spearwall them to death. This is how you engage more competent melee fighters, by spearwalling them to death. And there you go. They fell into the spearwall trap. And I believe victory is ours. Decisive victory. We didn't even need reinforcements. We just said, alright, spare wall this way, spare wall that way, and then spare wall and crush the enemy. A general of great merit should be said to be a man who has met with at least one great defeat. And that was Asakura Sohete, I think. So Yang Kuninaga refused to send out his forces to relieve his Joseon friendlies, and then Oda Nobunaga said, alright, we're just gonna end you here. You've just been sitting here for much too long. And we're gonna move them back. Oda Chikatsu. I'm gonna send him out. Occupy the settlement. I guess I'll send them back over here. Then our next big engagement. Oh crap. Not yet. In the next turn, this guy has not have the movement points to assist. And these monks, can you move anywhere? Okay, guess I'll end my turn here. We'll take the capital, most likely in the next turn, and also the and secure the eastern front from that settlement. And wow, lots of reinforcements are still coming up. Luckily I do that off screen, so then we can just focus on the Korean Peninsula. Otherwise, damn it, I will encourage migration. Doesn't really matter at this point. So what happened? Trident imprisoned. We lost a ninja. No! No, look at him. Look at him, he's dead on the ground. Imprison. They will return to service though, so that's good. Only knocked out temporarily. Oh jeez, I guess we'll just take the settlement. Not many. Royal Guards Garrison. Just one Royal Guards Garrison. The Mangonels! They'll just take anyone out. So looting will give us 8,000, not looting will give us 1,400. Doesn't really matter. We already have plenty of cash. Build a shinobi. Our way to Sakiden. Get a trading port. This settlement is extremely unhappy, so we'll just not have them pay taxes. And I guess we'll have to send these guys over. Oh, these guys are unhappy as well. Yeah, I'll just send this guy over. Then... yes, I'll send this army up to reinforce. This Korean garrison will have to be split. Keep the settlement extra happy. I'll minister the settlement. Okay, so two settlements left, I think. Maybe not. Two settlements left, however, I do want to check one thing. There used to be a trade route going down here. No way! Did we just find... we just found the cotton trade port. After all that time, we finally found it. That's what that island was that whole time. So, we can't use some trade ships here, but... yep, that's what this island was that whole time. A trade port. We just never noticed it. And now, giant naval fleet here. I can actually get some Red Seal ships. No, I cannot get some Red Seal ships. That's disappointing. So you get some Red Seal ships here in two turns time. And then we would have occupied every trade route, I think. We can't get any further up over here, I don't think. Have we even tried? That's the question. Yes, we have. And cannot sail further. Okay. That's fine. Can we just have you not move? And just have you sail back. Not a big deal. Okay. Have we ended the turn? Okay, yes we did. So we will... we can either take the settlement, that would be the smart thing to do, or we can force a field battle, which would be the less smart thing to do, but we'll do it anyways. So this is where the daimyo is, by Toshihide, with his son and heir in the general park, Yoritane. Mostly levies. We'll have to fight this one on the battlefield. Oh, we don't have to, but... we'll do it anyways. This is one of the probably last two battles we'll be having. And the art of giving orders is not to try to rectify the minor blunders and not be swayed by petty doubts. Not to be swayed by petty doubts. You must just be decisive in your orders. and very clear. So Battle of Kyojun. Start deployment in this hazy, hot weather. Oh, yes, so... this battle will be interesting because it's just going to be us charging the entire time. We're not gonna even stop, we're just gonna keep on marching. And we will have... pretty much the whole line. In fact, I'll just make this whole one giant line. So... let us do this. So we're gonna charge the enemy up this hill. I guess I'll come on this side. Wait, this side is where their reinforcements are coming from. So maybe not from that side, I'm gonna go on this side instead. Where my reinforcements are coming. Mostly just matchlocks, I actually don't need them. Well, they'll be useful. Over here. Do that. King of the Hill. This is literally just gonna be a King of the Hill battle. Enemies coming from behind, actually. Oh, that's pineapples. Alright, moving in. Spearmen, get out of there. Not that we can't take them, but... why bother? If we don't have to. Looks like their reinforcements are coming. Those freaking bodyguard units are shooting down my samurai units. So, we'll take them out. These monks are extremely experienced. Well, not that experienced, but they're experienced enough to be able to take down most of these dudes. And I actually need to utilize my cavalry, as they will be a huge help in destroying these archers. And the morale shock will be very useful. I keep marching up. By the time my cavalry get there, the battle's gonna be over. These guys have been sacrificed to take out these light cavalry units. Wow, look at that reinforcing army. Alright. Looks like where is a good spot to place these guys? Right over here. Get these guys over here. And victory will be ours. I'm gonna send these guys to help out. And these cavalry units need to get up there quickly. Provide the necessary relief for my men here. Those guys are shaken. Well, take the war cry and run away. I should not have them flank them in the back. Once the cavalry force flanks, it's over for these guys. They will shatter immediately. No doubt about it. And they are shattering almost immediately. The Naginatas are doing an excellent job. So we just need to, you know, not get shot by archers. A lot of these guys are not impervious to morale shocks. Which is good for us, because that's all we're doing, just doing morale shots. Alright, I'm gonna send these guys all out to help. And this guy. unit is losing, but I think they'll be able to hold on until reinforcements show up. Unless they get to flank to provide some relief. And those archers will go down. This will buy some time for these guys to survive a little longer. I'm gonna pull out my cavalry again. So that will buy us some time for those units. Notice how these guys stopped routing when we flanked the enemy. And then these reinforcements will... Oh, I can rally my men as well, so I'll do that. Inspire them. Morale shock, break these guys here. Didn't mean to blob these guys. Just happened to be that one. Alright, so we've disabled their archers over here. We'll disable these Korean bodyguards. Okay, looks like the reinforcements are all showing up. The monks are here. The Yard Cavalry will take care of these bodyguard units as they try to run away.
My lord,
they are putting up a pretty good fight, actually. Usually these archer units shatter pretty quickly. But not this time, surprisingly. Okay, there we go. Victory. Gonna have to try and rout most of these guys. You can see that... Wow. Monks are awesome. In fact, I can just throw the whole monk army and they'll be... They'll just win every battle. They're great attackers, defenders. The only thing is that they have terrible armor. But Ashigaru units have... Well, they have a little bit better armor, but that's because they have that armor. Otherwise, they have pretty much the same amount, I think. Or at least the default value. Okay. We've destroyed most of their forces. Autumn leaves... Wait, autumn tree shed leaves. Skinning the tree one by one until it is bare. Huh, I'm not quite sure I understand this one. It is a death poem, and I guess leaves aren't kinda dying, but is the tree dying? Okay, Yun Takanaga. Oh, we defeated their force right there. We didn't even need this reinforcing army. Only sent them there as an insurance policy. Do you need reinforcements? No, you do not. But I'm gonna send them in anyways. So our Yari Ashigaru took a pretty big hit initially. Oh no, we lost our light cavalry and two other units. But we did take the settlement, we secured the eastern front, finally, we killed the daimyo, we now have 855,000 koku. They're very good. I'm not going to replace those units. We'll repair the settlement, fill the sake den, build these guys up, some silver mines. And looks like there's one settlement left. We've taken the capital. I cannot march there. And I'll end my turn here once that monk finishes walking. Well, I think this might be the last episode. Yep, this is going to be the last episode of this... of this series, actually. So... I mean, I think this has been a very fun campaign. I think it's been 4 weeks of recording. Oh, ninjas.
This small group of highly trained ninja can kill a man and be safely home before anyone even realizes they were there.
Oh, ninjas. Awesome. So we got a new unit at the last turn, or at least at this turn. I think, you know, it's been like 4 weeks. It's been very fun. Every time I do some recording, I'm usually very excited. There have been some nights where it's just been really bad, but I think that's just sometimes what happens when you play these games. Just get really tired from work and then yeah. But I think yes, this campaign has been pretty awesome. I'm glad I did the Morning Sun mod, because it definitely adds an extra spice to the original campaign. The expanded Japan definitely added a new dynamic to the original campaign, whereas, you know, instead of four seasons, where every season, basically every turn mattered in the original game, so you would actually run out of turns before you can finish conquering Japan if you were very conservative. I usually only did long campaigns in the original as well, and I mean, there's this tiny settlement here, Yori Toshi and the Korean Archer Militia. But it's definitely been fun. I have been enjoying reading many of your comments, some tips and tricks, and also the support. So I'd like to thank you guys, the fans. You guys are awesome. And yeah, it's definitely been really fun. I don't know what I'll do next in terms of campaigns. I probably won't do another Shogun 2 campaign unless there's like... unless they add like the Ming Dynasty to the game, and you know, you can conquer all of China and the rest of Asia. Now that would be pretty sweet. So we have destroyed the Joseon Dynasty. We've taken all of Korea. Mototane has been released as well, and we have conquered everything here. And we'll build an encampment there, and also build a Buddhist temple. So, it's been a very long campaign, and we can reflect on some of the things here. We are the masters of peasantry. We are also the Shogun. We have the legendary Sojutsu school, which actually gives us +2 melee defense for all your units. I did not know that. Arsenal. So legendary buildings give you additional bonuses. I did not know that was a thing. Never actually managed to get that far. I always just beat the game. Never really needed legendary units. And we are filthy rich. We're almost at 1 million koku. 200 provinces owned. But yes, as I was saying earlier, when you have all of these additional provinces, it definitely makes the game a little bit more dynamic, so that you can gather troops faster. And since everything's a lot closer, you can do a lot more, and also a little bit quicker, but it does take a lot longer to conquer all of Japan, because you have to hit 200 different provinces, and man, we did a lot in 89 episodes. So let's just review the family tree. The Daimyo never actually died in this game. He did die rather early in real life. So then Oda Gozen ended up becoming the head of the household, because, you know, this guy wasn't of age, neither was Nobuyuki, but, you know, they had some bad blood. Nobunaga killed him, I think. And so you have all these other guys, and, you know, if this guy had passed away due to old age or from combat, we would have had the brothers, you know, move over here, and family tree would have looked a little different. We've lost very few generals. Takayama Muneyori has been with us since the beginning, which is why he's kind of angry. A little bit dependable. And we can review the map. We finally found the cotton trade post, and, you know, I thought we were going to conquer that, but turns out that it's not the case. And the Ashikaga declared war on us in 1557. It is now 1566. Turn number 259. We captured 199. Surprisingly, it doesn't say that we've captured... Oh, yes. We did only capture 199 because we've owned Owari since the beginning. We didn't lose it. We almost lost 400 units. We've destroyed over 4,100 units. And we finally recruited a hero, but we never actually got to use it. But, I mean, that's fine. Not a huge deal. We've seen them in custom battles. So, that's all you really need to see. Enlisted generals, 9. We lost 4 generals. No generals have been defected. And you can see the rest of the stats here. Lots of money. And yes, it's been a great campaign. I just want to thank you guys all again, and we'll see you in my next video. So thank you guys all for watching, and I'll see you next time.
Our hidden units have been discovered, my lord!